Many people care about their carbon footprint and they care about the energy that they use. And in daily life, they find lots of places where they try to make an impact. They think about the car they drive and how far, and they worry about what light bulbs they have. But there's this hidden place in life where people don't fully recognize the impact of their choices on carbon emissions and on energy, which is the food that they eat. So in a series of studies, colleagues and I looked at, first of all, do people calculate correctly how much energy and greenhouse gases are related to the food they eat? And then second, can we push them in a direction that once we make them aware of the impact, that would lead them to change their choices and the products they might buy? In the first study, we wanted to test people's understanding of how much energy and greenhouse gases are related to their food. And we did it by having people make estimates about specific foods, apples, beef, etc., and also for household appliances, so desktop computer and refrigerator. Partly we're building on past research showing that people underestimate the energy used by household appliances. We found that again, but we also found food was even more underestimated. We think this is psychologically interesting because we think, unlike a refrigerator, which obviously is plugged in and you can hear it rattle and you can kind of feel the heat coming from the back of it, we don't see that with food. We don't see all the industrial process that goes into putting beef on your table, and we think that's why people underestimate it. In the second study, we wanted to see if we could improve people's perceptions, and by improving their understanding, push them then toward food that had a lower carbon footprint. To actually do this, we gave people information about cans of soup, vegetable versus beef, and we were able to find that if we let people understand through using a very clear label that had a traffic light setup of green versus red, indicating kind of good and bad levels of carbon emissions, people in fact did shift their preferences away from the beef soup to the vegetable soup. So the larger message here is one of, this is a kind of hidden place where people don't have full understanding of their impact on the environment, and that if we just give them a bit more information, we might be able to help them end up in a place they'd rather be.